Do you want to know how to make a TikTok sound? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to make a ticking sound using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 2 alligator clips, 6 jumper wires, 2 10 microfarad capacitors, 1 red LED, 1 555 timer IC, 1 47,000 ohms resistor, 1 220 ohms resistor, 1 5 watt speaker, a battery holder with 4 AA batteries for the power source, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2, the trigger pin, initiates the timing interval in monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 serves as the output, providing the timer's operational result depending on its mode: monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4, the reset pin, is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 serves as the control pin, enabling you to adjust the threshold voltage levels used by the internal comparators to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6, the threshold pin, monitors the voltage of the capacitor in the circuit. Pin 7, the discharge pin, manages the timing capacitor's charge and discharge cycle. Pin 8, known as VCC, supplies power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 555 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 47,000 ohms resistor. Insert the 47,000 ohms resistor to pin 3 or output and pin 6 or threshold. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. Insert the shorter leg into the negative rail. Insert one leg of a red LED into pin 3 or output, and the other leg into 2 rows below the IC. Insert the shorter leg into pin 3. Bend the ends of a 220 ohms resistor. Insert one end of the 220 ohm resistor into the same row as the red LED and the other end into the positive rail. Turn the breadboard to the side. Insert one leg of a 10 microfarad capacitor into the positive rail and the other leg 3 rows above the 220 ohm resistor. Insert the longer leg into the positive rail. Turn the breadboard to the vertical position. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the 220 ohm resistor. Turn the breadboard to the horizontal position. Insert a jumper wire into pin 3 or output. Connect an alligator clip to the end of the jumper wire. Connect another alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Connect the alligator clips to the 5 ohm speaker. It's time to connect the power supply. Attach the negative lead from the battery holder to the negative rail. Attach the positive lead from the battery holder to the positive rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Tick, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock. It has the rhythm of a ticking clock. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. The 555 timer operates in a stable mode, continuously switching between high and low states. When power from the 6-volt battery is applied, the 10 microfarad capacitor charges through the 47,000 ohms resistor. The 10 microfarad capacitor on the left controls the frequency of oscillation. It works with the 47,000 ohms resistor to set how long the output stays high and low. Once the voltage across the capacitor reaches 2/3 of the supply voltage, the 555 timer toggles, and the capacitor starts discharging through pin 7 or discharge. When the voltage drops to 1/3 of the supply voltage, the timer toggles again, starting the next cycle. This process repeats, creating a square wave at pin 3 or output. The output of the 555 timer at pin 3 oscillates, rapidly turning the LED on and off. The 5-watt speaker produces a tone at the same frequency. The 10 microfarad capacitor on the right side smooths the waveform, affecting the sound quality. The speaker might produce a harsh, clicky, or distorted sound without it. It smooths the voltage transitions, making the sound from the speaker clearer and more pleasant. You can adjust the sound by adjusting the capacitor or resistor. For instance, the capacitor value is decreased to increase the frequency and achieve a higher pitched sound. In this case, it's reduced from 10 microfarads to 1 microfarad. Replace the 10 microfarads on both sides of the breadboard. The sound shifts from a rhythmic ticking to a fast ticking. Another option is to increase the capacitor value to decrease the frequency and achieve a lower pitched sound. In this case, it's increased from 10 microfarads to 47 microfarads. As in the previous example, replace the 10 microfarad capacitors on both sides of the breadboard. You now hear a slow extended ticking sound. I hope this video has shown you how to make a ticking sound with a 555 timer IC. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.